ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः प्रणम्य रामाभिधमात्मधीपदम् जगत्प्रसूतिस्थितिसंयमायनम् तदात्मकान् शङ्करपूर्वकान् गुरून् मयोपदेशार्थविभाग उच्यते Let us read the passage 23 कथं चाहं भिन्नजाति अन्वय संस्कारवर्जितः इत्येतच्छृणु योऽसौ नामरूपयोर्व्याकर्ता नामरूपधर्मविलक्षणः स एव नामरूपे व्याकुर्वन् सृष्ट्वा इदं शरीरं स्वयं संस्कारधर्मवर्जितः नामरूपे इह प्रविष्टः अन्यैः अदृष्टः स्वयं पश्यन् तथा अश्रुतश्रुण्वन् अमतो मन्वानः अविज्ञातो विजाननः सर्वाणि रूपाणि विचित्य धीरः नामानि कृत्वा विवदन्यदास्ते इति So the disciple had asked, how come the sharir, which is bhinna jati anvaya samskara sahitam or yuktam, the body that consists of all this, jati, birth, anvaya, the lineage, samskara, the various rites of passages, samskaras, ceremonies, that body, which includes both the gross as well as the subtle bodies, How come that is different? And how come I am different from that? So how is that different? The teacher described elaborately how this gross body as well as subtle body, both of them are created, both of them are nothing but matter called nāma-rūpāya. So ākāśo-ve nāma-rūpayo nirvahita. He taking that statement as a basis So, nama rupayo nirvahita, the manifest of name and form. So, name and form is the universe, but then universe is the effect, the cause also is the name and form. And so, that name and form is the very cause, is manifested by this akasha or paramatma. And so how is Atma different from the body? Yusav naam rupyaho vyakarta, that Akasha Paramatma, who is the vyakarta, the manifester of name and form. Naam rupa dharma vilakshana, naturally vilakshana, having characteristic quite different from naam and rupa, because vyakarta. Like a pot maker with a manifester of pot is different from pot. Seva naam rupe vyakurvan, that Paramatma who is distinct from name and form, vyakurvan, brings to differentiation, manifestation, name and form. Srishtva idam shariram, in the process of manifestation of naam rupa, the body of course is nothing but the manifestation of naam rupa. So srishtva idam shariram, that whole process was described earlier in the previous passage, how the body was created by Paramatma as name and form. Then, how is Paramatma different from this body? Says naam rupe. So, srishtva idam shariram swayam samskara dhanam varjita. Already said that the one that is a manifester of name and form is distinct from the name and form. So naturally, in name and form, they possess the samskaras, chati, anvaya, samskara. And therefore, to show that Paramatma is different from this body, mind, sense complex, he said he entered. Usually one who enters is different from the place or the entity where he enters, just to show that the Paramatma who enters is different from Nama Rupa, different from this body. If he has entered in all the bodies, how come we don't experience him, perceive him? Anyai adushta swayam pashyannam. The fact that seeing takes place shows that the consciousness is. Whether you can see the self or consciousness is not the criterion for the consciousness to be there. The fact that seeing takes place. So swayam pashyan, he sees. He eliminates that very act of seeing, anyahi adrishta. But then, the seer cannot be objectified and therefore he is not seen. Ashrutaha shrunvan. The fact that the hearing takes place means that there is a Paramatma in whose presence the hearing takes place. Without that, because the organ of hearing is material or unconscious by nature and it cannot function as a conscious entity, which it does, which shows that this Paramatma, the consciousness in whose presence this hearing takes place. Or amato manvanah, thinking takes place. Avijnato vijanand, knowing takes place. Paramatma such as that has entered this body. For validating this, here a mantra is quoted. Sarvani rupani vichitya dhiraha. Sarvani rupani sharirani vichitra virachaya. Having created all these shariras, bodies, dhiraha, dhiman, sarvajna, the Paramatma I refer to here as dhiraha. Dhiman, one that is possessed of buddhi or the knowledge. How much knowledge? Sarvajnaya, one is omniscient. Sarvani rupani vichitya dhira namani kritva. Tatra pravishya namani kritva. So this omniscient Lord, having created all these bodies, then gave name to them. Tatra pravishya, he entered these bodies and assume the various names corresponding to those bodies. Manushyoham devoham manushyam iti. அபிவதன் அபிவதனாதி வியாபாரம் குருவன். So who does all this vyapara of speaking? Abhivadanam, manushyoham, I am manushya, devoham, I am deva. Who says that? So the thing is that the speaker, hearer, thinker, knower, so he speaks. So who declares that I am a human being, I am a devata? Whoever declares that is the one that has entered this body and who performs the act of talking, seeing, etc. In what manner? Without identification. Without the, just in the presence of whom this act of speaking takes place. Also, tam vedame tam purusham mahantam adityavanam tamasastupare, etc. So, that is the mantra. Now, continuing, let us read further. Asminarthe shrutayah sahasrashah tatshrishtva tadevanupravishat antah pravishta shasta jananam seishaya pravishtah eshada atman. So, etameva simanam vidarya etaya dvara prapadyata esha sarvesha bhuteshu guhotma saiyam devata aikshata hanta aham imaha tisro devataha ityadyaha shrutayah. So this shrutaya could be, may or may not be there, not because the word the shrutayah came, shrutayah sahasrashah. Asmin arthe srashtuveva juru jivrupana praveshe. This artha, the srashta, the creator, means Ishvara. So, jiva-rupena praveshaha, the Ishvara is omniscient, omnipotent, omnipresent, the creator himself has entered this individual body, mind, sense complexes as a jiva. Important thing is, not how he entered, there is long discussion of taking entry in a primary sense, long discussions are there. And entry in primary sense cannot be explained at all. There cannot be entry of, because entry can be of someone who is not entered, but then just a space is already there when the pot is created. I mean, if a space has entered the pot, the purpose of entry is something else, not that a real entry takes place because space is already there where the pot is before it is created. So also consciousness is there before the body is created. So it's not there. There is no consciousness where the body is. And therefore, a non-present consciousness has to enter. That literally cannot be. So, purpose of entry is just to show that the one who is functioning as Jivatma is none other than Paramatma. That's all the purpose is. Secondly also, that Paramatma has entered here and therefore, Yo Veda Nihitam Guhaya, one who knows him in the guha, the cave of the intellect, so this is where he is to be known. That was the secondary meaning. Anyway, that's the primary meaning of Bhashyakara in Taittiriya Upanishad. But really, primary meaning is the one that is Jivatma is none other than Paramatma. So, Sashtuheva Jiva Rupena Pravesha. The Sashta alone has entered as the Jiva. Continuing the Tika, Brahmana Vakyanyape Atra Udaharade Tatsrishtva Ityadinan. Sri Sarvani Rupani Vichitya Dhiraha is Mantra Vakyam. Because it comes from Taittiriya Aranyaka anyway, but it's a mantra. Whereas this Taittiriya Upanishad is a Brahmana Upanishad. Therefore, Tasvishtva Tadevanu Pravishad. So very clearly, Taittiriya Upanishad says that Tasvishtva, having created all his body, etc., Paramatma himself entered. Antah Pravishta Shasta Jananam. Again comes from Taittiriya Aranyaka. So, Antah Pravishta Jananam Shasta. Shastra is what? The ruler. Jananam Shastra, the ruler of all the beings. Antah Pravishta. He has entered here. So he is the Antaryami also, the inner controller who has entered here. Again, Saishaya Pravishta from the Hrudayarnyaka Upanishad that we have seen a number of times. Tad Dedam Tadhi Avyakritam Asit Tad Nam Rupa Abhyame Avyakrita Asu Namayam Idam Rupaiti. That Paramatma was Avyakrita and manifested as this name and form, and assume this name and that form. Sesha, so having created names and forms, Sesha Iha Pravishtaha. That same Paramatma who created this name and form, or manifested as name and form, has entered here up to the tip of the nail. Eshate Atma Sarvantaraha. This is the Tikakara explained in the previous page, say here. Anyway, Eshada Atma Antaryamya Mrutaha Iti Vakya Sheshaha. So this comes from the dialogue with Sage Yajnavalkya, where he is asked, so if you want me to go back to that passage, this comes from the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, the third chapter of the Upanishad, which describes the dialogue that Sage Yajnavalkya had with the scholars in the court of King Janaka. Atha henam kaholaha kaushitakeyaha papracha. So Ushastha Chakarayana became quiet. Same question was asked again, Kahora, Kaushitakeya also asked Yajnavalkya, the Hova, Chahe Yajnavalkya. Yadeva Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma, Yatma Sravantara, Tammeva Chakshvedi. He Yajnavalkya, Yat Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma, the Atma that is Sakshad. So in fact, same question was asked by Ushastha Chakrayana also. So here the purpose is to in fact describe the sannyasa. But anyway, so yadeva sakshad aparokshad brahma, that indeed is the Brahman, that is sakshad, immediate aparoksha. So it is evident, immediately evident. Meaning that which does not require the intervention of the sense organs or the mind, sakshat aparoksham or sakshat aparokshat brahma. Aparoksha means immediate, and sakshat means without intervention. And this is the description of the self, that is immediate, without intervention, self-revealing. Yatma sarvantaraha. And that which is Atma, the Sarvantara, the innermost self of all. Tamme vyachakshveti, he Yajnavalkya, please explain that to me. See, Yajnavalkya, eshadatma sarvantarah. Your atma such as that is sarvantarah. That is sakshat aparokshat brahma, is your atma, that is sarvantarah. Is the indwelling self of all. Katmo Yajnavalkya sarvantarayati. He Yajnavalkya, there are many atmas. So katamaha, which one of them? Because the sense organs also are sometimes called atma, mind is called atma, intellect is called atma, prana is called atma. Yu ashanaya pipase shokam moham jaram mrutyumatyedi. Which is an atma which is sarvantara? The one that transcends the ashanaya pipase, the hunger and thirst, shokam moham, grief and delusion, jaram mrutyum, old age and death. Is the atma sarvantara ityartha. So, atma such as this, your atma, is the self of all. Meaning that, the one atma alone is the self of all the, self of all, that's the idea. Who is that atma? Ashanaya pipase, the one who transcends all the samsara dharma such as hunger and thirst, old age and death, grief and delusion. So that is your atma. So you who think that is why then earlier it was said, but which one? You have to tell me what exactly, what is that nature of that atma? Na drishte dastaram pashye na shute shrutaram shrumiyaha, etc. So he is said earlier, adrushto drashta ashruta shrota. That is your atma. That is your atma. That is the self of all. And that is your atma. Not what you take to be as a drashta, shrota, etc. But then, one that illumines the drashta, shrota. So this was the idea there. Then next sentence was, etameva simana vidarya etvara dvara prapadyata. That Tikakara explains, in fact. Saha ikshana purvakam jagat srishtva etameva prasiddham simanam shirah kapala sandhim vidarya mitva etaya brahmarandravachaya dvara chidrena prapadyata deha madhye pravishtaha ityarthaha. This comes from the Aitareya Upanishad. This is a long description there also of creation. Same thing. There also a very elaborate description is given as to how this body is created. A long story is told as to how Paramatma alone was. This whole universe was nothing but Atma before its creation. Atma va idamekeva grasi nanyat kinchana mishat. That Atma deliberated Lokanu Srijayati. May I create the Lokas, and the four Lokas were created. Then Lokapalas were created. Then five elements were created. Then this body was created. The Devatas were, etc. The whole infrastructure is created. Then the food was created, everything was ready. Then Saikshada. So imagine that the Paramatma has created this body, mind, sense complex, and all the objects which are to be experienced by this complex, everything is ready. Saikshada. Kathannidam madrute syadati. Then that Paramatma deliberated that what will be the use of all this without me? Madhrute maam paraswaminama katham nukena prakarena khalusyat sthitam bhaved. How will this exist without me? What will the purpose of this without me? What's the use of experience without the experiencer? The organs of perception bring variety of experiences, but if the experiencer is not there, what will the purpose? The organs of action perform variety of actions for the one who performs the actions. If that is karta, bhokta is not there, then what's the use of the sense organs of perception and organs of action in the mind and intellect? If thinker is not there, knower is not there, what's the use of all these instruments? And therefore, Parameshwara Ikshanam Kritavan Nahi Puraswayanamina Purasya Puravasinam Rachana Shobhate. What's the point of creating the whole town and also the various indwellers of the town? If the master of the town, the king, is not there, what's the point of all of them? Because they are all meant for him. Puraswami means the master or the lord of the pura or the city or the town. And the whole town and all infrastructure is created for the lord. If he is not there, what's the use of all of this? Ata bhogaswamina maya jivrupene dehe praveshtavyam. Similarly, bhogaswami, namely I, if I am not there in this body, mind, sense complex, then what will the use of this? Therefore, maya bhogaswamina maya jivrupena praveshtavya mityartha. Therefore, I should enter the jiva as bhogaswami. Because all the sense, the objects, in the organs of perception, all of these is created of bhoga for experiences. And I, the master of bhoga, that is the experiencer, is not there, what's the use of all of this? Therefore, I have to enter. Then, now there are two passages from where the entry can take place. Pravesha marga ikshana swarupa sa ikshara katarena prapadyeti. Of which two gates? One is at the crown of the head, other is at the toe of the right foot. You can enter one of them. So, dovatra pravesha margau padagram murdni brahmarandram cha. It is said that there are two entry points in his body. One is at the tip of the toe, other is the crown of the head called brahmarandra. Tayo madhye katarena kena margena prapadye. Both these entry points are available to me. By which shall I enter this body? Kayagana sangalakshan puramam pravishani iti ikshata. This is what he delivered. Evam kathanidam ityadi vakye jivro praveshasya dehendriyadi vyavahara palana prayojana muktam. The purpose of the Paramatma entering this body, mind, sense complex as jiva is so that the organs of perception, organs of action, all of these can perform their respective functions meaningfully. Idanim atmajnano prayojanantras ikshramah. But that's not the only purpose. Paramatma has entered this upadhi not just to perform the vyavahara, of course, that is so, But then, Atma Gyanaro Prayojanam. The purpose also is the self-knowledge for which the Paramatma is here. And therefore, another ikshanam was carried out. So different ikshanas are there. First, the ikshata, first he deliberated, what is the point of all of this without me? Then he had deliberated of the two gates, the doors available, by which, through which door shall I enter? So ikshata, again he deliberated. Yadi vacha abhivyahrutam, yadi pranan abhipranitam, yadi chakshusha drishtam, yadi shrotirana shrutam, yadi tvacha sprashtam, yadi manata dhyatam, yadi apana abhyapanitam, etc., etc. Kohamiti. He says, if the organ of speech is speaking, organ of hearing is hearing, organ of sight is seeing, the mind is thinking, the intellect is knowing, etc., etc., then kohamiti, then who am I? So this is a deliberation for the self-knowledge, koham. Yadi vacha vagindriyena abhivyahrutam, yadi, so if this organ of speech performs the act of speaking, etc., and all the various organs perform their respective organs, including mind and intellect, yadi aham karyakarana sangatam anupravishya vagadi abhivyahrutadi phalam upalabheyam atha. So then, if I am the one who enters this and gains the benefit of the functioning of all of these because the organ of speech is speaking for this one, the organ of hearing is hearing for, so if I am the beneficiary of the functions performed by all these organs of perception and action and etc., atharana koham kim swarupa kasyava swami bhavayam koham, then who am I? What's my swarupa? What's my nature? Or kasyava swami bhavayam, whose master will I be? Atah asti kaschit dehadi vyatirikta chidatma sacha parabrahma rupa yadina kopi maam janiyat. If I do not enter, then nobody will know me. That there is a Chidatma or consciousness which is different from this body, mind, sense complex. And that Atma is Parabrahma Swarupa, the nature of Parambrahma. Na kopi maam janiyat. If I am not here, then nobody will ever have a jignasa or, you know, even in a curiosity, you know. Yadatu ahameva saravyapan. If organ of speech alone performs its function, and the mind pumps on, if they are all able to do their own self without me, let us say, then what will be the purpose of all of this? Says, yadatu ahameva saravyaparam karta. So two choices are there. One is the organ of speech is performing the act of talking on its own. If they do all of this, then who am I? What's purpose? On the other hand, if organ of speech is talking because of me, in my presence, organ of hearing is hearing in my presence, ahameva saravyaparanam karta. I am the agent of all these activities of agent of speaking, hearing, thinking, knowing, etc. Vagadesu mara prairitaha santah abhivadanadikriya kuryu. In all the various organs of speech, they were all prompted by me. They are all enlivened by me, and then they perform their vyavahara. Tadatu vagadi karuna vyapasta kartruko bhavitamarhati kriyatva. Then this question will arise. that whenever any action takes place, there must be an agent in the performance of the action. The act of speaking takes place, there must be a speaker. If act of hearing takes place, there must be a hearer. Act of thinking takes place, there must be a thinker. Kriyatvat sakartruko bhavitamari vyapara. Any activity must necessarily have an agent to perform that activity, because that's the nature of activity. If the act of splitting the wood takes place, there must be a splitter, whether you see him or not. The act of pot making takes place, there must be a pot maker, whether you see him or not. So even though you do not see, adrushto drashta ashruta shrota, is unseen, seer, unheard, hearer, but still, the fact that seeing, hearing, all these activities take place, that means you can infer that there must be an agent who performs his actions, or so kene sitam patati preshitam mana, this question can arise in mind of somebody. Provided thinking takes place, hearing takes place, speaking takes place, then a question can arise. That all these activities can take place provided there is an agent, there is an entity who performs the activities, or in whose presence the activities are performed. So kene sitam, prompted by whom, directed by whom, or in whose presence these things take place. Iti mat sadbhava anumatum shakyate. Ishvara says that only if I am here, performing the functions of hearing and speaking and thinking, etc., then someday people will think that because hearing takes place, there must be a hearer. Because thinking takes place, there must be a thinker. And that way, even though they do not think of the thinker, they do not hear the hearer, they do not see the seer. Meaning that the jivatma is not pratyaksha or directly perceived, but he can be inferred. Ko hyavanyat kaf pranyat yadesh akasha anando nasyat. The fact that the act of breathing in and out take place means that there must be a conscious being. Because prana itself is inert or unconscious. Still, unconscious prana performs its acts. I mean, there must be someone in whose presence is activity. That is how you infer the presence of a conscious being. So, mat sadbhava anumatum shakyate. So, that way Paramatma thinks that if I am here performing his activity, then someday somebody will have a jignasa. Who is this one in whose presence these things are taking place? Eva meva anumanena atmasadbhava usastha brahmanepi samamnata arilio yav pranena praneti sate atma sarvantarayeti. Yav pranena praneti, one who performs the act of breathing out by prana, that is your atma. So this is how the description is given in the Aitareya Upanishad. So we read this. Sa ikshana purukam sa jagasrashta, that creator of the universe, ikshana purukam, as preceded by ikshanam, etameva prasiddham simanam. Sa etameva simanam vidare etvara dvara prapadyata. Evam vagadi karananam vyavahar siddhe mat avagate cha. So purpose of entry on the part of Paramatma was twofold. One is only when the Paramatma of the nature of consciousness is there, that all the vyavahara of speaking etc. can take place. And secondly, if he is there, then someday also a question can arise in mind of somebody as to who is it who is responsible for this vyavahara. So, mad avagate cha, for knowledge of mine also, this Anumanam is possible, and therefore someday somebody may want to know me. Maya avashyam atra pravesh, avashyam atra pravesh tavyam. For these two purposes, I must necessarily enter here. So this was the decision. Idi ikshanam krutva, so this was the purpose of the second ikshanam. So etameva simanam vidarya, etaya dvara prapadyate. Saha parameshvara padagra margasya bhrutti sevidasya. So the tika said, because there are two paths, as we say, you know, two do pravesha margav, padagram murdni, brahmarandram cha, as we said, that supposedly the two entry points in this body, one is the padagram, the tip of the toe, and the other is the crown of the head. So padagram margasya bhutya sevitasya nikrishtatva. But the entry point, the tip of the toe is the lowest point, is like the back door meant for servants. The house also, there is a main door and there is a back door. The back door is meant for servants, the main door is meant for the master. So I am the master of the Upadhyaya, I am not the servant. The prana is the servant who performs all the activities for me, and therefore the prana would enter through the lower gate door, I will enter through the topmost door. Padagra margasya bhrutya sevitasya nikrushtatvad. That entry point which is at the tip of the toe is meant for the servant, ever it is inferior. Parisheshat uttamidam dvaram jnatva. If that is inferior, then naturally this entry point at the crown of the head is superior, is meant for the master. Srashta Ishvara etameva murda madhyavagam eva simanam vidarya. Therefore, he split open here this point, which is a meeting point of this kapala or the hairline also. So, etaya dvara, etaya brahmarandravachaya dvara. Chidrena prapadyata dehamadhi pravishta ityartha. And that is how the Paramatma entered through this top entry point of Brahmarandra. So this is what our Atma Puranakara Swami Vidyanandaji Vidyaranya also explained, that Lord Krishna entered the city of Dwarika from the top. So when Lord Krishna came from Mathura to Dwarika, how did he come? Not through the gale, the land path. He in fact flew and entered from the top of Dwarika, because Dwarika stands for this, and Lord Krishna stands for the master of this Dwarika. And so he entered from the top. So idea is that here is the Jivatma is none other than Paramatma. That's the whole point here. Then the text also said, Esha sarvesh bhuteshu gudotmana prakashate. Kathopanishad says that this Atma is Gudha. The Atma, the self, is hidden sarvesh in all the beings, na prakashate. But then he is not recognized as such. Sarvesh bhuteshu guda Atma. Understand, Atma is singular. Sarveshu bhuteshu, in all the beings. So one Atma dwells as the self of all the beings. Then Sayam Devata Aikshata Hanta Am Imahatisro Devata Ityadya Shrutaya. That comes from the Chandogya Upanishad. Tasam trivitam trivitam ekaikam karvaniti. Before that, Swayam Devata Aikshata Hanta Haimaha Tisro Devataha Anina Jivena Atma Anupravishya Naam Rupe Vyakarvaniti. In Chandogya Upanishad, process is similar. If not identical, it is similar. In each case, ikshanam is carried out, deliberation carried out before the act of entering. So there also, that one, the sat, there is ekameva dvityam, one without a second, ikshata, it's deliberated, and that's how the element fire was created. Then the element, so sat as element fire deliberated, then element water was created. Again, sat as water deliberated, element earth was created. So these three elements are created, called three devatas. You can say nama rupa basically. So three elements are created or nama rupa are created. And then sayam devata aikshata sa prakta im avyavitokta srashtu devata. That sat or Brahman, one without a second, is called devata. Alaukakatvat avyakratakhya devata. So this Paramatma is called devata alaukikatvat, because it's not laukika. It's not perceptible like, you know, what is available here. So it's called devata. Self-revealing as well as beyond the perception of sense organs mind. Aikshara. Katham hanta idane maham chin matra rupamanena buddhista puro sushti anubhutena jivena pranadrita hetuna atmana sadrupena aham. I will enter. Who am I? Chin matra rupa anena buddhista puro sushti anubhutena jivena Atmana sadrupena yama srishtaha. So as the very Atma, as the very Sat, I will enter these three elements which have been created as their Atma. So meaning that the Paramatma entered the name and form as the Atma of three elements or Atma of name and form. Surya Pratimvat Anupravishya Bhashyakara very clearly explains what is the nature of entry, that Paramatma created these three elements or the name and form or the Dupadhi and then entered as Jivatma. What is the nature of entry? Surya Pratimvat Anupravishya, just as the sun enters a pool of water. So entry is like sun really entering the pool of water or being reflected in the pool of water. Looks like sun has entered the water. When you look at the water and see the reflection within that water, it creates the impression that sun has entered the water. That's all. There's no real entry. There is as though entry, appearance of an entry. So also it's not that Paramatma has entered in a primary sense, he gets reflected in this body-mind-sense complex. Tad deha vimanavati bhutva. What's the purpose of saying entry? Identifying with this name and form of the body-mind-sense complex. Naam rupe naam na rupena cha tat sukshapinde vyakarvani asau namayam idam rupaidi vyakurvam namayani gurtva abhivadanyadaste. So then it entered and gave name or assumed name for everything for a corresponding form. In short, the process is described in different words, but process is very similar in more than one Upanishad. How? The Paramatma himself has entered this body-mind-sense complex as a Jivatma. I mean, the one that obtains a Jivatma is none other than Paramatma. And that's what you are. टीकाकार गिव्स दोन फर्दर सेंटेंसेस अंतःप्रविष्टं कर्तारमेतम् अगेन फ्रॉम तैत्तिरीय आरण्यक सो अंतःप्रविष्ट शास्ता जनानां सिमिलरली आल्सो अंतःप्रविष्टं कर्तारमेतम् आइदर यू कॉल इन जनानां शास्ता The Paramatma is entered here is the ruler of all the beings or Kartaram. He is the agent of performance of all activities here also. Idrashta, Shrota, Amanta, for whose presence the Darshanam, Shravanam, Mananam take place. Bhartasan Brihamano Bibharti. Eko Devaha Bahuda Nivishtaha the Tika. You don't have that, perhaps we have a footnote here, footnote number 14 here. See, Bhartasan Brihamano Bibharti, look at the sentence, Eko Devaha Bahuda Nivishtaha, Nivishtaha San Nivishtaha. So the footnote explains this Vakya. Yoyam Pranabhimani Devaha Soyam Bharta Poshakasan Bhartasan. Bhartam is the one that sustains, Poshakasan. So, one who sustains, one who nourishes Bharta. So, who is the Bharta here? Who is the one that is Poshaka, the nourisher, sustainer here? Yoyam Prana Abhimani Devaha. First, identifying the Prana, Soyam Bharta Poshakasan. He alone is the Poshaka or the sustainer here. Brihamana antaryamina parameshwarena swayam dhariyamana san. So one is bharta here. So karta, bhokta, bharta, etc. As the Bhagavad Gita, the 13th chapter says here in the, what did it say? Upadrashtanamantacha bharta, bhokta, maheshwara, paramatmedi chapyukta dehesmin purushapara. Bharta, Bhokta, Maheshwara. That Paramatma, Dehesmin, Purushapara. In this very body, that Parav Purusha, the Supreme Paramatma is called Bharta, Bhokta, Maheshwara. Upadrashta, Anumanta. So he himself is sustained by Paramatma and then he sustains his body. So Paramatma, identify with the prana, then sustain this body. So, Bharatasan Brihamano, Brihamana, one who himself sustained. Bivadi, the one who is sustained, sustains. So, Paramatma sustains this Jivatma who sustains this body, mind, sense complex. Meaning that for Paramatma to sustain this, he cannot sustain Adu Vyavahara as he is in the Paramadhika Satta. He must also acquire the Vyavaharik Satta. That is the whole idea of Pravesha. As Param Brahma, he cannot directly perform functions in his body. As Jivatma, he can. So he gets identified as body, mind, sense complex. It's called Jivatma. As Jivatma, then he performs all the various functions. Deham dharayati, so bivarti, deham dharayati, who sustains his body, this Paramatma. Pranopalakshita, lingashira, tadatma, adhyasa, adityartha. So Paramatma has adhyasa or identification with the prana or the sukshma sharira. Prana stands above lingashira, sukshma sharira. Meaning that Paramatma, what is meant by entry is identifying with the sukshma sharira. So, sukshma sharira is enlivened called the jivatma, and that in turn sustains this sthula sharira or this body mind, the body sense complex. Evamcha jiva prana dharanati dhatu avi sangachate. That's how jiva means prana dharanam, sustaining the pranas or maintaining the pranas, holding the pranas. This Paramatma first becomes Jivatma by identifying with the Sukshma Sharira. And then he sustains the prana or the sthula sharira also. Then the Tika further says, the last sentence, Indram Mitram Varunam Agni Mahuhu Atho Divyasya Suparno Garutma Atho Divyasya Suparno Garutman Ekam Sad Vipra Bahudha Vadante Agnim Yamam Matarishvana Mahuhu. Comes from the Rukveda. Ityadi Mantra Brahmana Vadani Api Atra Suchayati Ityadya Shrutaya Iti. So what we quoted and these others also, Mantra Brahmana Vadani, the mantra and the Brahmana. So this again is a mantra coming from the Ruk Samhita, Indram Mitram Varunam Agnim Ahuhu. They call him Indra and Mitra and Varuna and Agni. Atho Divyaha Sa Suparno Garutman, the self-shining Suparna. Suparna means the Garuda or the eagle is also Devata. Garutman Suparna. Garutman is Garud. Means the eagle with beautiful wings or feathers, so that Divya, the divine. So the divine eagle having beautiful feathers. Ekam sat vipraha bahudha vadanti. Sat is one. Paramatma is one. Vipraha bahudha vadanti. Vipra, the wise people or the learned people, vadanti, call him by different names. What Agnim Yamam Matarishvana Mahuhu? They call him Agni, Yama, Matarishva. All of these are different devatas. So people thought that each devata is different from the other devata. Agni is one devata, Matarishva is another one, Yama is another one, Agni is one, Varuna is another one. Which in a way is also, each devata has its own personality, his own powers, his own jurisdiction, and each devata can bless the devotees and fulfill their desires. So in that sense, these devatas have some distinguishing features. There's no doubt about that. Names and forms are many. And still, Ekam Sat, all this called Indra, Mitra, Varuna, Agni, Matarishva, etc., etc., are none other than one Sat, one Paramatma. Bahudha Vadanti, one alone is called by or mentioned by or referred by different names. Iti. So in all of this, these passages are all meant to show how there is an entity distinct from this Upadhi. Indra, Mitra, Varuna, Agni, all of these are the names of Upadhi, Nama Rupa. Indra is a Nama and there is a corresponding Rupa. Mitra is Nama, corresponding Rupa. So names and forms are described here. Ekam Sat, all the names and forms are nothing but the designations of one Sat or one Paramatma. So who is different from the Nama Rupa? Because he's entered this. He's a self of this or he's entered this. That is how all of these passages very clearly describe how there is this Nama Rupa, which is the Upadhi, which is called the body. And there is another entity which has entered this body. And that entity is none other than Srashta or the Creator, the Paramatma has entered. Not somebody else. So kamayata, tasvishtva tadevanu pravishata, saha is Paramatma. So all along the one who has entered is avyakrata, call him avyakrata, call him the Atma, call him Paramatma. He alone is mentioned as, described as, enter this upadhi called nama and rupa. So how the nama rupa upadhi is possessed all these bhinna jati, anvaya, samskara, etc. And how atma, there is one distinct from this. There are two entities here. One entity is called this body, the gross and subtle body, which is endowed with this bhinna jati anvaya samskara. And this another entity that is totally distinct from that and totally devoid of it, or that transcends all this jati anvaya samskara. So that there are two entities here. One is upadhi, other is a upaheta. One upadhi, other is a self. Okay, we'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru Bhyo